Okay, I was going to do a follow-up video on the automatic temperature controller I built. I built this for two reasons. One is I wanted to do overnight cooks so I could set this up and feel very confident that I wouldn't have to worry about the temperature. My ugly drum smoker did a very good job of keeping the temperature overnight. I really didn't have that many problems with it, so this just added a little bit more comfort, just knowing that the temperature was being controlled. Second reason for building this is I'm in the electronics field, so this is just kind of a hobby project for me, and I wanted to try it, so that's why another reason I did this. There are many options when it comes to building your own do-it-yourself temperature controller, and after doing some research, I decided to use an Auber PID controller. I chose to use the Auber universal PID temperature controller that's 12 or 24 volts. I chose that because I could use a DC power supply to power both the controller and the blower fan. You can also buy thermocouples and other temp controller hardware and accessories from Auber. Or if you prefer, you can just buy a complete smoker temperature controller from them, and it's pretty reasonably priced. So what I've got here is an Auber temperature controller. I've just mounted it into a simple aluminum housing. Got this from a scrap bin at work. On the back here, you've got the connector here on the left is that is the power connector. That's where I plug an AC to DC 12 volt power connector to it. This is your thermocouple connection right here, and then this right here is for the fan. I used like a 1/8 inch mono headphone jack for that. That was pretty simple to use, and you can find those at Radio Shack or wherever. This right here is the power switch. It turns it on and off. Okay, so this is the second part of my controller. This is the actual blower motor, and it's just in a plastic hobby box. It is basically a small 12 volt DC fan that comes out of a computer. I think it was like an old CPU cooling fan that I had lying around. So I just mounted that in the box, and then again, I used the 1/8 inch mono headphone jack or connector, and then got the jacks and then run the cable up, and then it goes up here to the controller. It plugs in right here. Then, like I said, I got the thermocouple plugged in right here. It goes over, and then I've got it going into my smoker here. And I just put it kind of in the center here of my smoker, and you can see the sensor there, the thermocouple sensor. And then here's the 12 volt power supply. It goes, and I've got it just to this 12 volt power supply I had lying around. I can't even remember what that went to. It went to some kind of electronic equipment around the house that we don't have anymore, but I always keep that kind of stuff lying around. All right, so you get the controller and you turn the power on here, press the button, and right now it's basically showing what the air temperature is right now. It's about 86 degrees outside where I'm at. So you can hear it just kick the fan in, so it's trying to bring the temperature up right now. Right now I press the up button and I've got it set to 250, and it's real simple. You just hit that up and down and set your temperature, and then it'll stay at that temperature, whatever you set it to. I can take it down to 240, and that's what it'll be set to. The set button, that it really gets into the menu, and that's how you control some of the PID functions, and the Auber manual will show you how to set all the variables for your PID controller, and it's pretty simple. You set it that one time, you really don't have to worry about it anymore after that. They have really good settings. It's for smokers, and it works really well. It usually keeps my temperature within probably within 5 degrees of whatever the set temperature is without having to worry about anything. So you can hear now the fan is running, and it's running for extended amount of time now because it knows that the temperature is not going up. So it's smart enough to know that depending on how fast the temperature is going up or down, how long to turn the fan on and how often to turn it on. So that's the smart function of a PID controller, and it works really well. Also, you can see here I've got this valve. When I get through with my cook, I can shut that off and close all the other the vents on my top here to shut it down and save on charcoal. I just use these magnets here to cover up my vents. And I have other valves. I don't have to use the temperature controller. Right? I've got that valve, and then I've just got a plug or a cover for that vent there. So I can cook without the controller, but I've just got to where I enjoy playing around with it, so I use the temperature controller to do all my cooks. Another tool I use is this Maverick ET732. It has two probe inlets. Normally one's for your barbecue or the smoker temp, and the other one's for whatever you're cooking, the meat temperature. Sometimes I use it to monitor two different pieces of meat. Like the last time I cooked a brisket and a pork butt, I used two probes, one for each for the brisket and one for the pork butt. So that came in handy. A lot of times when I'm doing an overnight cook, I'll use the smoker temperature and monitor that. And then I can set an alarm on my remote unit that I can keep next to the bed or whatever. And if the UDS smoker gets below a certain temperature or over a certain temperature, alarm will go off and it'll wake me up. Fortunately, with this controller and as well as the UDS works, that hasn't been a problem. I haven't had to get up in the middle of the night and fool with it. It stays, like I said, within 5 degrees during the whole cook. I've cooked as long as 15 to 16 hours without even having to fiddle with anything. And the only time that I had to do it before that was I didn't fill my basket all the way up, so my temperature started dropping after about 16 hours. But if I fill my basket up, I could probably cook 20 hours on this thing. That's how efficient this drum smoker is. So that's kind of gives you a rundown of the temperature controller and how it works and how I've got everything connected. If you got any questions, just shoot me an email and I'll be glad to answer any questions you have.